Okay, so today our topic is the driving pressure, and it's presented by our PICU senior fellow, Dr. Ahmad Bukhari. Go ahead, Ahmad.
The outline of the driving pressure, is it safety limit or a goal of a goal for mechanical ventilation? So acute respiratory distress syndrome is a life-threatening condition of seriously ill patient characterized by poor oxygenation, pulmonary infiltrate, and acuity of onset. There are reports of 30 to 40% mortality until the 1990s. By understanding and advancement in mechanical ventilation and earlier antibiotic administration and selection, mortality rate are now around 9 to 20%. The current guidelines for lung protective ventilation in patients with ARDS suggest the use of low tidal volume according to the ideal body weight and higher level of PEEP to limit ventilator-induced lung injury. Airway driving pressure, considerable attention after application by Ahmad et al. Analysis showed that the driving pressure as opposed to tidal volume and PEEP was the variable that best correlated with survival in patients with ARDS. Several authors have replicated this hypothesis in different clinical scenarios to the point of suggesting that driving pressure may be a goal in itself. The role of driving pressure, considering it more as a safety limit than an objective by itself in the current clinical evidence, restricted to patients undergoing controlled mechanical ventilation and without spontaneous breathing effort. In 1990s, several studies that limiting tidal volume or airway pressure during mechanical ventilation might improve the outcome. In a pioneering single center study, Amato et al. Showed a reduction in mortality using a strategy based on maintaining low inspiratory driving pressure lower than 20 centimeters of water, along with tidal volume and high PEEP level. Large multi-center by ARDS network trial showed a decrease in mortality by nearly 25% in more than 800 patients with ARDS using 6 instead of 12 ml per kg of tidal volume. There was some controversy about the best way to titrate the tidal volume is to ideal body weight, body surface area, lung size, airway pressure. The rationale of limiting tidal volume emerged from the description of the concept of baby lung, that in ARDS we are facing physiologically small lungs and not rigid as previously thought. While oxygenation and shunt were correlated with non-aerated tissue, static lung compliance was strongly correlated with the residual aerated lung volume. Driving pressure. What is the driving pressure? The driving pressure is the pressure required for the alveolar opening. It's equal to the plateau pressure minus PEEP. It's also expressed as tidal volume over static lung compliance. So the high driving pressure indicates poor lung condition and decreased lung compliance. The transpulmonary pressure is the pressure difference across the entire lung from the opening of the pulmonary airway to the pleural surface. And the transpulmonary driving pressure is the driving pressure minus the inspiratory esophageal pressure minus expiratory esophageal pressure. But the transpulmonary driving pressure is not equal to the driving pressure. What is the lung compliance? Lung compliance is defined as the change in the lung volume per unit change in the transmural pressure gradient. So the compliance may be described as a static or dynamic depending on the method of the measurement. So static compliance is measured after the lung have been healed at fixed volume for as long as is practicable. Dynamic compliance is usually measured in the course of normal rhythmic breathing. As you can see here, the static compliance is the volume of air is inhaled from the functional residual capacity, and the subject then relaxes against the closed airway. It's easy to measure lung compliance in upright position and total compliance in the anesthetized paralyzed patient who will usually will be in the supine position. But the dynamic compliance is simultaneous measurement of tidal volume and airway pressure create a pressure volume loop. This measurement are made during rhythmic breathing. It's calculated from pressure and volume measurement made when no gas is flowing, usually at end of inspiratory and end of expiratory with no flow point. The relationship between driving pressure and tidal volume. In 9 patients with ARDS, we applied both ventilatory strategies from the original ARDS network study, 6 and 12 ml per kg ideal body weight at constant PEEP of 9 cm of water. The use of lower tidal volume decreased airway pressure. As you can see, the in comparison for both groups, the driving pressure 11.6 versus 22.7 with 12 ml per kg with significant B value less than 0.01. They conducted a retrospective analysis of 150 deeply sedated paralyzed patients with ARDS in which a PEEP trial of 5 and 15 centimeters of water was performed at constant tidal volume and respiratory rate at both PEEP levels. The higher airway driving pressure group had significantly higher lung stress, respiratory system, and lung elastance compared to the lower airway driving pressure group. More importantly, airway driving pressure was significantly related to lung stress, and driving pressure higher than 15 centimeters of water was associated with a dangerous level of stress. What is the current clinical evidence? The evidence relating to the outcome, the first described in 2002 in a prospective observational cohort of 235 patients with ARDS, the driving pressure during the first week constantly discriminated between survival and non-survival, along with other variables such as PEEP ratio and SOFA score. More than a decade later, the best evidence came from Ahmad et al. With the meta-analysis of 9 prospective trials involving more than 3,500 patients that showed that driving pressure was the physical variable that best correlated with survival in patients with ARDS. After the report by Amato, several authors confirmed the association of driving pressure with survival in patients with ARDS. And 56 patients with ARDS suggested that the ventilation strategies leading to decreased driving pressure and elastance could be associated with improved survival. The ultra-protective ventilation with extracorporeal lung support may help to protect the lung by decreasing tidal volume along with driving pressure. In a recent meta-analysis from 9 studies, including more than 500 patients receiving ECMO for refractory hypoxemia, showed that driving pressure during the first 3 days in ECMO had independent association with in-hospital mortality. Although ECMO support allowed decreasing tidal volume to 4 ml per kg and driving pressure in nearly 4 cm of water, the non-survival still showed a higher driving pressure during ECMO. In the largest observational study, in nearly 2,400 patients with ARDS driving pressure of more than 14 centimeters of water was associated with an increased risk of hospital mortality in patients with moderate and severe ARDS. The evidence related to physiological alteration, one of the problems when setting the ventilation in ARDS patient is the right ventricular overload, which relate to the lung decrochment and overdistension, and has also been reported to independently associated with a poor prognosis. In a prospective observational study in 226 patients with moderate to severe ARDS ventilated with plateau pressure limited to 30 centimeters of water and assist with the transesophageal echocardiography, core pulmonary was detected in 49 patients, around 22% higher driving pressure were an independent factor associated with core pulmonary. More recently, a driving pressure above 18 centimeter of water and PF ratio less than 150 and PCO2 more than 48 millimeter of mercury have been associated to promote right ventricular failure in patients with ARDS caused by pneumonia. The evidence related modification in driving pressure with outcome. Despite all above evidence association, driving pressure with clinical and physiological outcome, no study to date has evaluated driving pressure as primary goal during ventilatory setting in patients with ARDS. In the surgical setting, a recent meta-analysis involving 17 clinical studies and 2,250 patients showed that change in the level of PEEP that resulted in an increase in driving pressure were associated with more post-operative pulmonary complications. The meta-analysis of Amato et al. When analyzing modification to driving pressure, which occurred as a result of a specific change in a tidal volume or PEEP applied after randomization, those changes that led to a decrease in driving pressure were associated with a greater survival. The clinical use of driving pressure. The safe limit of driving pressure have been not been identified, and the suggested cutoff vary from 14 to 18 centimeter of water. Comparing high versus low tidal volume ventilation in patients with ARDS, a conventional non-protective strategies resulted in driving pressure greater than 20 centimeter of water, while protective one were usually below 15 to 16 centimeter of water. In contrast, in studies comparing high versus low PEEP in which all group limit tidal volume, mean driving pressure were well below 15 centimeter of water. As you can see here, the protective strategies and control group, the most significant one is done by the ARDS network at Amato. While they are fixing the tidal volume and optimizing the PEEP, the driving pressure was almost 15, with mortality rate around 30 to 40%. While the tidal volume was increased above 10, almost 11, almost 12, with driving pressure increased from 15 to 24 to 27, the mortality rate was increased with significant PEEP value. The other application of the other study using the high PEEP versus low PEEP, there is no significant difference between the mortality rate in both groups. In the absence of prospective studies using driving pressure as a goal when setting the ventilator, we suggest that driving pressure should be used as a complement to and not as substitute for tidal volume. So driving pressure may be a valuable tool to set PEEP independent of the strategy used to titrate PEEP. Change in PEEP level should consider the impact on driving pressure beside other variables such as gas exchange and hemodynamics. a decrease in driving pressure after increasing P will necessarily reflect recruitment and a decrease in cyclic strain. In conclusion, airway driving pressure represents the cyclic strain to which the lung parenchyma is subjected during each ventilatory cycle. It's a physiological way of adjusting tidal volume to the residual lung size, and is associated with survival in patients with ARDS. Adjusting ventilatory support with traditional protective parameters, tidal volume 6 to 8 ml, and moderate PEEP, and adjusting them according to the driving pressure should ideally be below 15 centimeters of water. Thank you for your attention. Any questions?